This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island. From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. Hey, this land was made, you and me. As I was walking that ribbon of highways, I saw above me that in the skyways, I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me.
Now from your news channel, the latest breaking news, county by county coverage and weather on the nines. This is Bay News 9
with his first toy train.
And when you test the horn, means the horn is working.
Except this isn't a toy. It's Gunther's business and Life Museum of Science and Industry. It's a master plan that Mosey's research team is pretty excited about.
I think there are some innovative aspects of the monorail system that aren't found locally, and one is the ability to move cargo as well as people within this system. It also has a regenerative energy system so that it conserves energy, stores it, and can be used later on.
That means no gasoline is needed for this train. It runs purely by the energy of the sun. That's one reason why a couple of state senators are supporting this effort. Bay Area Senators Victor Criss and Mike Fasano reportedly believe this could be a prototype for more research and possibly get the engine running for monorail mass transportation in Florida. This is a model of what the Mosey train would look like.
This is going to hold 20 plus people, and they're going to start and stop all day long.
Gunther has the plan. All he needs now is the money.
For mass transit is called the SkyTrain. See why it may be coming to the Bay Area next. So first, it's on a new form of transportation that could make its debut here in the Tampa Bay area. Fox 13's Lloyd Sauer shows us what it would look like and where it would be built.
When you think of a monorail, you might think of Disney World. But beneath the Tampa sun, Whit Ostrenko looks for a new way to move people around Mosey.
Starting off on the far end of the parking lot, which is about 3/8 of a mile away, it'll start there, come to the front entrance of the Science Center, go by the Science Center, and down to the far end, which is another half a mile away.
Mosey's master plan shows 75 acres of new buildings and attractions, even a hotel. Too far to walk, so now plans call for a SkyTrain. This scale model shows the passenger car hangs beneath the track. Its steel wheels are more energy efficient than rubber tires like the Disney monorail uses. It would be solar powered, and it actually recovers energy as it operates.
When you stop, instead of putting metal, brake shoes, when you stop, you say, I'm not going to use metal-to-metal brake shoes. I'm going to make my motors into generators, and all that energy I'm going to capture.
Carl Gunther is one of the designers. He says the SkyTrain on poles in the air takes up little space on the ground with no delays.
We need to get to the third dimension of transportation. Leave the roads to the cars and the buses.
New place for the futuristic SkyTrain.
Well, this is going to be a great exhibit because it's going to show energy alternatives. It's going to be powered by the sun. It's going to be a solar voltaic cells that will power this unmanned vehicles around the site.
Mosey is asking the state for $2 million to get the SkyTrain started, hoping public interest grows as the SkyTrain goes up.
Ostrenko envisions the SkyTrain connecting with USF and other parts of the city.
There's got to be an alternative system so that when Tampa continues to grow, that we have other means of transportation to move people around.
Gunther has the plan. All he needs now is the money.
We'll turn on.
Supporters say building the SkyTrain at Mosey now may put it on track for the future of mass transit. Lloyd Sauers, Fox 13 News.
Well, if the legislature approves, construction on the SkyTrain at Mosey could begin within 2 years. We'll certainly keep you posted.